properly. So that is called as a diseases. Let me have discuss about the two types of diseases. Which are that? Can you recall? Yes, communicable and non-communicable diseases. Now, what is meant by the non-communicable diseases? The diseases which are not spread by person to person is called as a non-communicable diseases. And what is meant by the communicable diseases? The communicable diseases means what? The diseases which are spread by one person to another, that is called as a communicable diseases. Now, already we have learned the diseases which are caused by the non-communicable and communicable. For example, the non-communicable diseases such as kwashiorkor, marasmus, goiter, and we have discussed about the what are the symptoms and what are the sources of food. How to take care of our, if the particular child has got a particular disease, then how to take care of that diseases, that is sources of food. Which food items should be given to that particular person? Then we have discussed about communicable diseases. The communicable diseases means what? The diseases which are spread by one person to another. The diseases which are spread by one person to another. So that diseases are called as a communicable diseases. Then these diseases are spread through bacteria, virus, and protozoa. These are nothing but microorganism. These are nothing but bacteria, virus, protozoa. These are nothing but microorganism. What is meant by the microorganism? Can you tell me what is meant by the microorganism? Micro means a very small particles which we cannot see by our naked eyes. We have to use the telescope. So they are very small particles, very small germs which are spread by the different types of wind. So today in this lecture we are going to see how the communicable diseases are spread. The spread of communicable diseases. There are the different ways the diseases can be spread. First by air, food and water when any person comes in a direct contact, and by the insect. So these are the microorganisms or the germs are spread. See, everywhere the air is there, am I right? So there are very small particles which are, or very small germs are spread through the air, which are spread through the air. If a healthy person, if it comes in a contact with that particular microorganism, then he can be affected. That person will get a disease, or that person will get an affected by the particular germs, and he can cause a different types of diseases such as common cold, diphtheria, flu, whooping cough, and tuberculosis. The person can get such kind of diseases: common cold, diphtheria, flu, whooping cough, and tuberculosis. This, when any sick person, if he is having cough or sneezing, if it comes directly contact with a healthy person, the germs are spread directly to that healthy person and can be affected. So we have to take care of person comes in a contact with an infected person by the by his or her cloth or any food or anything, if he is in contact with a particular instrument, and if any person touches that cloth or the thing, then he may get infected. So direct contact, for example, diseases are spread through the direct contacts of chickenpox, ringworm, measles, and common cold. These are the diseases which are spread by the direct contact. Then the next is through insect. This diseases which are spread through the insect. Now you might be knowing the diseases like malaria, plague. These are spread through the insect. For example, insect, that is anopheles mosquitoes, the diseases are spread by the diseases through the insect, that is malaria. The mosquito spread the disease called as a malaria. Then Aedes mosquitoes spread dengue. Then rat fleas spread plague. These are the diseases which are spread by the insect. These two are spread by the mosquitoes, and by the rat fleas, the disease name plague is spread through it. So the diseases are spread by the communicable diseases when by through air, through food and water, when any person comes in a direct contact, and by the insects. So these are the spread through the communicable diseases. Then the next is how to prevent the communicable diseases. Now see, these are the diseases which are spread by the different ways, these air, food, water, direct contact and insects. So to prevent them, how to protect the communicable diseases, we can prevent it by, you should take the bath regularly. You should bath regularly. See, there are some prevention ways are given in your book. But before that, there are two MCQs. So we'll just go through it. See, what is caused by the deficiency of vitamin A? Nitrites. Yes, stick to the A, everyone. Then chickenpox, ringworm, measles spread through the direct contact. Yes, B option. So stick to there. Yes. Now the next is how to prevent the communicable diseases. We have to take a bath regularly. You have to take a bath regularly. Then next is the house should be disinfected. Means you have to clean the house. You have to keep your area clean. The garbage should be thrown in the dustbin. Now you know the dry and the wet waste, right? So you have to throw in a proper dustbin. Drinking water should be clean. Whatever, it should be filter water. You are drinking the water. It should be a filter water. You have to drink the clean and pure water. The surrounding should be neat and clean. Then the children should be vaccinated every time. What is meant by the vaccination? We are going to learn in the next video. So I hope that you have understood this spread of communicable diseases and how to prevent the communicable diseases. Then the today's work is that you have to remove the new words. You have to write the new words up till now and read the lesson twice. Thank you.